Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Mustafa Kalkan. I'm here with a new video. With the school season starting, today I want to talk to you about a very valuable molecule in brain health called Citicoline. I already have a video where I generally talked about supplements for the school period. Also, don't forget to check the video titled Forget Forgetfulness. I've made a comprehensive video about molecules used in brain health, but today I want to go into a bit more detail about Citicoline, which has become quite popular in recent years. What is Citicoline? Citicoline is a mononucleotide containing cytosine, ribose, phosphate, and choline. It's a valuable molecule because it can carry important molecules to our brain in a packaged form. You might have already heard of some molecules like phosphatidylcholine and phosphatidylserine. These can be taken as separate molecules. There are phosphatidylserine supplements, phosphatidylcholine supplements. Citicoline reaches the brain in a packaged form and can be taken up by nerve cells in the brain. It is the only molecule that can synthesize three phospholipids at once, which are crucial for cell membrane and myelin sheath functions. What are they? One of them is phosphatidylcholine. One is phosphatidylserine and another is phosphatidylethanolamine. It has the ability to synthesize these three essential phospholipids. And where are they crucial? Especially in the functions of the myelin sheath. They are transmitted in our nerve cells. There are myelin sheaths that ensure the rapid transmission of phosphates and cover the nerve cells. This allows us to quickly recall information previously stored in our brain or rapidly solve processes. And the most important phospholipid contributing to the structure of the myelin sheath is phosphatidylserine. At the same time, there are certain molecules called neurotransmitters in our brain, which help with learning, memory, and recalling past information, such as serotonin. Serotonin, for example, contributes to happiness. Dopamine provides a sense of pleasure, while acetylcholine is the primary neurotransmitter responsible for learning. There are also some medications prescribed to Alzheimer's patients from the group of acetylcholine steroid inhibitors. What do these aim to do? Two things. By blocking the enzyme that breaks down acetylcholine between neurons, we aim to increase acetylcholine activity in the brain for a longer duration. This is the goal of those treatments, figuring out how we can increase the acetylcholine in the brain. The aim of the treatment is to prevent the existing acetylcholine from breaking down more and to ensure it stays longer between neurons naturally. So acetylcholine is a The way to support its production relies on increasing the amount of choline in the brain phosphatidylcholine to synthesize its production. This then converts to acetylcholine in the brain. One of the main molecules that increase acetylcholine in the brain is from our system. We can normally get choline from foods, but a study conducted in European societies showed that while we need 500 mg of choline per day, they could only meet 8 to 10% of this with diet alone. There is no study conducted in Turkish society, but since we generally have similar dietary habits, we can say we do not get enough choline from our diet either. After citicoline enters the bloodstream, it splits into citidine and uridine, and this allows it to cross the blood-brain barrier. Once in the brain, it combines to contribute to the synthesis of phospholipids I mentioned earlier. Citidine and uridine can also combine in the synthesis of phosphatidylcholine. And at the same time in DNA RNA synthesis. And are also important molecules for restoring cellular energy. Citicoline is also a methyl donor that supports the functioning of the methylation cycle. I've talked about the methylation cycle in great detail in previous videos. Remember, for cardiovascular diseases, it combats high levels of homocysteine, which is a risk factor, purging homocysteine from the body and synthesizing antioxidants like glutathione in the methylation cycle. Acetylcholine also fights homocysteine by providing the molecules called methyl that drive this methylation cycle. This in turn helps in the synthesis of neurotransmitters like serotonin and acetylcholine. Just as homocysteine can clog heart vessels and cause a heart attack, It can also clog the brain's vessels, potentially disrupting brain health long term and needing to be cleared from the body. Citicoline helps combat homocysteine, thereby supporting the vascular health of the brain. Citicoline also supports a compound called cardiolipin. It also ensures the synthesis of a molecule. Cardiolipin is a molecule that is involved in energy production in the mitochondria and fights mitochondrial dysfunction. In this way, it also supports the brain's energy mechanism. As you know, the brain tissue is one of the organs in our body that consumes the most energy, and so does the cardiac muscle. The skeletal muscle and the brain are among these organs. These are the tissues that work constantly in the body and require the most energy. Citicoline supports the brain's energy systems, contributing to brain health in this way. The effects of citicoline on memory, attention, focus, and brain health have been shown in many studies. For example, in one study, a group of 6 to 7 people, middle-aged participants who took 500 mg of citicoline supplement daily for 6 weeks showed a 26% increase in brain cell formation and a 13.6% increase in brain energy production. Likewise, in the adolescent population, a dosage of 250 or 500 mg for only 28 days showed an increase in brain functions. This also showed significant improvement in motor speed. It has also been proven to significantly benefit attention parameters. In another study conducted on a group of 50 to 75 people, it was shown to provide significant benefits in both general memory and episodic memory with the use of citicoline supplements. As you can see, there are many studies conducted with citicoline in doses of 250 mg or 500 mg. Here, for general health support, focus, attention, memory, and brain health, you can use 250 to 300 mg per day. If there is an issue like forgetfulness, Alzheimer's, or the onset of dementia, you can use 500 to 600 mg of citicoline supplement daily. Studies have shown that citicoline is safe up to 2 grams per day. I can say that it is a very safe molecule. In addition to brain health, new benefits of citicoline have started to emerge. I shared these in a story at a conference I attended this week. By the way, you can also follow me on Instagram at elemustafakalkan. You can benefit from momentary updates. It has been demonstrated that citicoline has significant benefits for eye health as well. There are important studies conducted on glaucoma. It has been shown to improve retinal health. Many new studies on citicoline's benefits over glaucoma have also started to be published. If you have any problems with your eyes, keep citicoline supplementation in mind. Yes, these are the general points I wanted to mention about citicoline. You can also read the book titled Scientific Supplement Guide for the Prudent, written by myself for other questions you might have about supplements. Additionally, you can follow me on instagram.com.rmustafakalkan. See you in future videos. Goodbye. Stay healthy.